Dude, heads
So,
out though.
welcome everyone. We will be now flipping a coin for the initial position in game number one for hostile or AFK versus BAM. I have Bats versus Green there. I have Steel Fusion Esports Blue there. That's not happening.
Unlucky.
Oh my goodness.
Never mind. Oops. So let's just jump right for the flip coin. So Hippo, you said tails, right?
Did say tails.
All right. So let's see what's gonna land. And it's heads. Oops.
Yeah.
Oops. So you guys are, I will give you the invite right, and you are free to join the side that you actually want to pick.
Alright, we're taking the blue side for first game.
Alright then.
Sure.
And we will be coming back soon, TM, with the game number one. Hello everyone, it's me, MG Voodoo, and here with me is your favorite MG Wrath.
Bro, I'm trying to eat a chocolate lava cake here, and you just start the stream!
Hello everyone, it's well, you didn't tell me you're eating, how should I know?
So you were supposed to assume I'm eating something. We all know how fat I am.
Well, you're supposed to be an army. Are you suggesting that you fat army soldier?
Whoa. I'm mentally fat. Like, physical perfection, but mentally fat. I feel like fat's more of an attitude and a mentality than, like, a physical thing. Because I see fat people out there that, like, they run every day. They're trying to lose weight. They barely eat anything. It's just their genetics. Those people aren't fat in my mind. Those people just like have like, I just feel bad for those people. Like they're tried so hard, you know?
And come so far and in the end it doesn't even matter. All right, so today we were supposed to be playing with I'm missing it all the time. Okay, so we've been supposed to be playing against out of the Discord team. We've been supposed to be playing against, and of course, Glow just changed it, so I cannot read it from Evans. All right, never mind. But I guess our team scared them just too much, so they did not show up. So instead, we will be giving you a game with Hostile AFK versus MG Fabulous 5. MG Fabulous 5 will, for some reason, will not be playing in their full supplement. The Kitome decides that she rather plays Norms than Scrims, so there will be substitute with a bag of bees. We seen a lot of bees last night with his bard and first kills on him. So we will see how it goes in this in-house scrim, so to speak. We're waiting for a fifth member of Hostiles. They are at this moment, he's rushing back to his house, poor guy, and he will be here really quick. And Wrath, you there?
Yeah, still here.
Awesome. Can you at everyone and link the MG Momentum Gaming stream in the general chat, please?
Wait, what was that?
Never mind.
I was gonna say, what are you on about, Voodoo? Are you losing it, bro?
At everyone, and by that, everyone not here on stream yet, we'll be playing MG Fab 5 versus MG AFK, which they are really AFK. And number one, bam, bam.
And I'll be back momentarily. I'm gonna go for a cigarette while we wait for this last guy to get here.
Oh, that's bad for your health, man.
Dude, life is bad for your health.
Military is bad for your health.
Dude, literally, like, the world gives you cancer. Yo, the headset that's on your head right now, that's giving you cancer. The computer screen you're sitting in front of, it's giving you cancer, man. The keyboard you're clicking on, it also gives you cancer. You microwave your food, cancer.
Yeah.
Put aluminum foil on your food in the oven, cancer. We're literally dying from the moment we're born, Voodoo, so yeah, you might as well enjoy it to the fullest.
From experience, playing with Vrat, cancer. Wink, wink.
Right? Like, you instantly get cancer the moment you face me, but I'll be back shortly.
All right. So, just for the conversation, to keep it to keep it going, so to speak, the teams had flip a coin, and the Fabulous Five will be starting on the red first on the red side. The AFKs will be starting on blue. Funny part, the Fabulous Five actually had the opportunity to pick, and they chose to start on the red. Even though the most of the teams are, if they have the opportunity, they will be starting on blue. It might be also a fact that in the game number two, the sides rotate, so they may just want to have in that decisive number two game, they want to have that edge of having a blue side. And I really want to see how it will end with the bans for this game, since it's in-house. The people play with each other, they train with each other, so they know what the other team is playing. They know it really good. So, since Jace Onderello, the captain of the AFK team, is... I mean, he has a Jace, his main, in his name. There, you cannot really do anything about that. So, I suspect we will see that Jace, but we always see Jace banned. And I'm really looking forward to if Bag of Bees, who is Bart main, if we're going to see him play something else, because yesterday when he was playing, we heard suggestions of Malzahar support, and we saw a Brand support from him. Really well played, I have to say. And the last player of MGFK is logging in, so we should be starting soon, TM. And oh my god, this someone who's logged into Momentum Gaming Twitch account, and I actually would like to see that, to be honest. I have zero idea what entertaining would what would you do to entertain. Just from reading that chat. So, we might see. There might be a surprise, a hidden surprise on the chat, on the stream soon, maybe. Lol. And it actually arrived.
Momentum Gaming. Homie said, say my name, and know that I'm right. So, I don't know, I can't sing. Beer? What's up? He's running dry because we're on a pause, and yeah, homie, check the thing, because your mic is way too loud, louder than the host. But other than that, I shouldn't be in here, but I'm here.
Ooh, my.
It's kind of funny because there's like a delay. I bet you I can run up there and go see it. All right, I'm
I'm out. I'll be back.
Oh, you didn't brought me a beer?
Hold on. No, that... Are we allowed to do that on camera?
No. That's like, I don't... No. They only...
This... Where the fuck's the camera?
They're here.
This is a Pepsi? It's just a Pepsi?
Yeah, it's a golden with white foam. Other than that, it's a...
Show me your what? Your beard?
Beard. Yeah, it's, he has nice beard. I mean, look at that.
You didn't see that, did you?
Well...
Oh, it's delayed. Like, that's funny.
Yeah, it's... Well,
mine's better. I have to trim it because I have to eat food.
But my is best. I mean, it's like, you see, it's the special kind that grows only like on certain parts of your body. So it's like, here's spot, and there's two, and that's a hole. And I am not sure.
Dude. Alright, I'm going back up to watch. I'll be back.
Alright.
Let me know.
Okay, that was the biggest fan of Momentum Gaming departure right now.
If you need me, just text me.
Yeah.
Right now.
Cheers. And for of those of you watching the stream, there is on the Discord. The glow sticks is in stream viewing room. So if you guys want to talk to each other, have some fun, jump into the channel over there with him. He's poor guy all alone there. And... So far, it looks that, you know, it's like when your girlfriend tells you that I will be good to go in 5 minutes, you know, and it was like, even though that she said 5 minutes, you really know that you translate it to I will be done in 15. Well, I think that's what's happening right here, because I'm reading in the room chat that our missing guy is logging in, and that was like... 5 minutes ago. So. That's the. Do I see it properly? Oh my god. We actually have all the people that we need. And. Nice. So. Cheers, guys, and don't be afraid. Glow's not biting. Just go join the hashtag.
All right.
Stream room. Nope, it's. Room. So Vrat is here, so I don't need to entertain the public anymore because our best guy for entertainment just arrived.
What do you mean? I'm not even here, dude. What are you talking about? You're losing it, Voodoo. You're losing it.
I always losing it. I just got myself a beer from from a good fairy that just stopped by to say hi.
Drunk Voodoo talking about fairies and shit. Here we go, boys.
Yep. And not speaking about that Nevada now has free rein on smoking marijuana, so it could be worse since I'm here.
But, feel it. Well, we have 40 seconds to start this custom game.
Do we?
Yep. 35 seconds. Ooh, less time than I thought.
Are you freaking kidding me?
Dude, you guys need to calculate your lives more.
the hell?
Like, everything in my life is calculated. Like, I came back. I calculated that I'd come back just in time for that Grizzly guy to get here so he'd start the match.
This is just full out retarded. All right, so let's get everyone. What the hell? I cannot even give them.
Ooh.
His mic? Alright, so for some reason this is so embarrassing.
Yeah, Voodoo, you fucked up, man. You done goofed.
Yeah, but the thing, I cannot invite anyone. What the hell?
Up. Well, Ritto just cucked me, dude. I tried to play a video on the home screen. Something about, like, the shot caller, right?
Yeah, the playmaker?
Yeah, it,
That was a garbage video.
Yeah, it crashed my client. That's how garbage it was.
Alright, so we have some technical issues because Ritto is, of course, not behaving as it should be behaving. And client is just doing whatever he wants. Where I cannot actually invite people to lobby and lobby expired and stuff. So
just have someone else set up the room, fam.
Yeah, I already trying to do that. So I will actually be right
hey, you're back.
I'm back, and we are all reloading. It looks like that fixed the problem. So if you did do it yet, Vrat, try to reload the.
Well, I mean, I already told you, man. Ritto already made my client crash because, like, I tried to play that garbage video, but it was so garbage that it, like, crashed my client.
And it was in, like, Italy. I don't know if it was in Brazil. What? Brazilian? Or is it like Spain or something? It was horrible. It's loading. And alright, here goes the invites. Spectate. And ooh, so we are guys really, really sorry. Like, we are really, really sorry. Like, really, really sorry.
I'm not sorry. I'm never sorry.
Yeah, you never are sorry. And that's sad. Sad, sad. It's a sad world. Mad world.
Please stop.
You wanna cry? You're getting all emotional on me?
No, it's just hearing your voice hurts my soul.
Oh, come on. It's not that bad. And, so, with only a 33-minute delay compared to where we are supposed to start, I mean, that's pretty much on time. I mean, hey, it could be, it's still better than ever, right?
Oh, yeah, definitely, dude.
Yeah, yeah. You need to always look on the bright side of life. And I would sing the Monty Python song, but Vrat would not like me if I did that, so I will not do it.
Yep.
And I don't really care about Vrat, so always look on the bright side of life. Na-da, 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 na-da. And we're basically one person again. What the hell?
I'm so done with you.
No. It's Asuka's there. Asuka's there. Everything's alright. Everything's alright. I swear to God, everything's right. And, so, let's this party started. Boom. And everyone. And yep, we will be watching Note feeding. Yep. Go. Let's go. And here it goes, guys, as promised. What the hell?
Nice.
For those of you that did not notice, that was Jace Durello making a blind pick lobby instead of tournament draft. So I think we should have actually gone with that. Just no regrets. Go blind pick to scream. And of course, B has a time to chat in Discord with the pretty girls instead of getting himself into the room. Spectate. I want spectate. Rat.
What's up? I haven't gotten any invites, dude.
Yeah. And wait, here you go. Switch to the spectate with me. So, surprisingly, we still have 15 people watching us, even after all those...
Why? You're so bad.
Total fails. Well, you do realize that you are here with me, right? So, it's not just...
It's not my job. Like, you're the one failing here.
That you just hurt my feelings, because I most likely have more of them than just one. So, we are trying to get that sorted out. You see, we have full lobby now. Tournament draft. Here it goes. after additional 5 minutes. We're terribly sorry, guys. We're terribly, terribly sorry. So, first ban for team AFK. Let's see. And Zerat. I cannot even remember last time I saw someone playing Zerat.
All things have consequence.
And Kalista. I can't remember that either.
Voodoo?
Yeah.
I lied.
I
just got called back into work to go shovel snow.
You need to maintain your physical readiness.
If I want your opinion,
stuff.
I'll beat it out
of you.
Yeah,
at 9:40 p.m. on a Saturday night. That's what I should totally be working. Dude, fuck the Arby. All right, I gotta head back to work.
Impure fools.
All right, man. See ya.
Yeah, I'll talk to you later, bro.
And so, on without co-shotcaster. Rip. Rip me. So, is there someone watching who would actually want to... Yep, rip Wrath. He totally deserted us. But we have that Vayne ban, we have that Vi and Sonya, because
come on,
you know,
I won't
Sonya
hurt you.
Ban for
I
Corgi.
Promise.
I don't know why they banned him, because yesterday when Corgi was playing Sonya, it did really good, went good, and by really good, I mean like it didn't went good at all, like at all. So. We will see what is going to happen, what he's going to pick. He still have the option to go for his normal Orianna pick, which are totally viable. But we see first Nautilus. And I'm not sure if that's actually top or if that's support node. Yes. I have a phone on my ear. Yeah. Well, yeah. We can I will give you a link to join on the So, that solves that problem. At least, I think so. And... in the meantime, as we see Karma and Zyra. So that will be definitely... That might be actually Nautilus jungle. Ooh, that is something really interesting. Right there. And... Lol. No. Let's do it totally different. Sorry for the noise. And so with me here, is now the one and only, the best person with the most lovely beard.
Hello.
Titus. Hello, Titus. Me? Yeah, I can hear you. I can hear you. It would be nice if you actually, guys, in the chat, if you let us know if you can.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
What? Can you hear me?
Yep, still can hear you. Still can hear you. So, as it looks like, this stream is like total fucking shitstorm. And I have like zero idea what we'll be actually, what we are actually doing right here. But now we will have 3.5 minutes before the game starts. I'm sharing my screen, so you should see what's going on. We will see how is that going to play. And we will.
I'm kind of confused because I'm watching the delay.
You're watching the delay, and do you like the delay? just watch the hangout. I think it should have a shorter delay for the game than
Well, how am I supposed to commentate on something that I'm like watching like 10 minutes late?
No, hangouts should
be on hangouts, bro. You're not sharing your screen.
What? It says I do. I am.
Share your screen so that I can see it.
Is it now going? Do you see something? Maybe? Damn. What the hell is this? What is this crap? I hate this crap. This is BS. This is BS, like total BS. I don't know. I have like zero idea what's going on.
Do I get to put my pretty face on TV too?
Yes, I'm actually working on it right now. But, oh, display capture? Is it? Nope.
Oh, jeez.
Jeez. We still have 1 minute to figure it out. So we are not. You're allowed to vape and you're allowed to drink. Let's do window capture. That should work. All right. So. Lol.
I got a burp.
Damn.
Okay.
What the hell? I hate this. I hate this.
So I don't see you on the page.
Rip. This is horrible.
You want two more monitors?
Yes, actually. One more would be enough. Image, slideshow, media source, scene, text, video. I guess it's window.
Ah, now I see your screen on.
Yeah, you do?
Shibby dibby dibby. But I don't know what that means.
You don't know what that means yet, but it will be coming there soon, TM. I hope so. So, hey, everyone, we are loading in. For some reason, I'm totally... Is Momentum Gaming the Final Fantasy chapter? We will see a note feeding and bees stealing all the kills from his AD carry. And how do you like the pictures? As someone who does who never played this game, how do you like the pictures of the champions? And he doesn't even talk
to me. Know that I know absolutely nothing about this game.
And that's why we have a shoutcaster that
they
have
are sexy. Well, some of them are sexy.
Are you actually listening to stream or are you listening to the Hangout? Because you should listen to the Hangout.
I guess I'm listening to the stream.
Yeah, since you are like 20 seconds behind, then I'm assuming that that's correct. And for some reason, it looks like a bag of bees who we are making fun of is not connecting. So that's something we totally need because it's like 48 minutes after we were supposed to be starting, and that doesn't fare well for our normal schedule. Ooh. All right. Can you hear me now? Test. Ooh, hoo, 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 hoo. No. All right. So that sucks. F out. Can you hear me? Ooh. No. Wow. This is so freaking BS. Can you hear me now? Would you like to build a snowman? Hmm. You sure you don't have it muted somewhere? Damn. Alright, so this is like, oh, we're in the game, as I asked. So yeah, of course we will see the pause right now because people were waiting for a bee to actually get in. And since we know he reconnected because it actually let us into the game, then that is really, really unfortunate. So today is a day that we were not granted the normal schedule of our And the Pauls
don't hear anything.
And the Pauls
a rookie.
And the Pauls end it. And we see both teams running finally towards what we were waiting for past 50 minutes. I have to thank you again, guys, for actually bearing with us. We usually don't have trouble like this. I swear to God, we don't.
I can hear you now.
Awesome. Awesome. I think awesome.
Is it instant?
And I should be. I mean,
okay, you're looking at Mr. Grizz the Joe Boobies.
Yeah, yeah. I have 1 minute in game right now. 1 minute, 5 seconds now. On the top, middle, under the 0-0 is a counter.
1-0-10.
Yep, yeah, exactly. So it's life. It's life. Ooh.
Okay, we got our crap together. Awesome. So now.
Yeah. Yeah.
We can make this more entertaining than the last hour.
Of crap. That was not entertaining at all.
Mr. Voodoo, what am I looking at here? I see a dude standing in the water about ready to beat some ass on some dude on the actual side of the ocean shore. He moved it.
Yep, it moved. It moved on. It's moving on its own. So the whole point of this game is to win. Is to get on the other map, kill as many enemy as you can.
I understand that. I mean, like the other day, I guess these guys were running the middle and then busting a right up there to go to the corner and then, like, you know, take that half of the map. I don't know if these guys do the same thing, but
well,
conquest. It's all about beating some.
And we'll see that back left the game. Oops. So it looks like we have some connection issues there on the side of back. Yeah, so, well, the thing of it is, like, they have totally different champions, so it's like they have different combination of what they can do against each other. So it depends on their skill, mm-hmm. what they're going to do, mm-hmm. And those icons, that animation they're flashing above their head, it's like that's master icon. It's basically just BMing, trying to be like, oh hey, look at me, I have that fancy icon, you know, I'm the best, I know how to play, which they don't in reality. And
so when you have a sync error, is that what that is?
Yeah, it looks like the bag of bees.
Bag of bees.
Yeah, that was the guy that was standing on that what you call shore.
It's like Minecraft or something.
Yeah, bag of bees. The right guy with the laser, right there, has some trouble connecting issues.
So am I supposed to be cheering for a certain side here? Or am I just supposed to bash everybody?
Ooh, yeah, you're supposed to bash everyone. And Galleon had to burn Flash, but Ignite did not kill him. The potion saved his life, and he actually canceled his recall, and he's staying in the lane, which, against Garen, don't think really smart idea, but he's back to half hit points, and some nice poke damage there from Asuka. Note tries to prove that he's best, but we all know how it's gonna end. He's just gonna die a lot, and that will be the end. Unfortunate end. Yeah, it's like I don't understand what you don't like. It's like, of course I'm the expert. It's like the point of any game is to win. That's the basic rule right there. Point of the game is to win the game. And we have a 4 minutes in and nothing really interesting except the top lane. Gallant tried to dodge, even though it's like I'm not really sure if that works. Oh no. The judgment, and in the meantime, a nice exchange damage between Cyanic Acid and the Bag of Bees. It's really interesting to see Bees not playing support. He's usually on the bottom side of the map instead of the middle side. It's like total different strategies, of course, you know. And Unchained had to burn his flash to escape the gank that Summoner tried to follow up. I'm brain dead, to be honest. Like,
are you brain dead, bro?
Yes.
I can help fill in the gap. I was just trying to make sure my configurations are going, because for some reason now both my damn microphones are running at the same time.
That's actually my both microphones are running as well. But
do I sound like shit?
No, you sound good.
Do I sound sexy?
You sexy and you know it.
Should we get a room?
Nope.
That's not me, bro.
That's me. So. Everyone else, I'm surprised. That was Thunderlock proc from Joe, and Gallant managed to escape with 200 hit points, barely, again. And in the meantime, Beast taking a lot of damage, the empowered Q from Karma. Eat a huge chunk of his...
Bro, why can't you full screen me? Why can't I see my pretty face down there?
Well, because you're actually watching that, and there's a first blood coming down into a grace, and that is really unfortunate for Grizz to meet a Gallant there again after he TP'd in. And in the meantime, Acid's trying to, it will flash, and that auto attack on the max range followed Beast to the death. That was really nice done by Acid. And on the top line, it looks everything went back to normal. Durello didn't really have enough damage on his Nautilus to hinder Gallant in any significant way. And Note is exchanging the damage with Luxfury. That's like, we need more confusing names. We have Theatrical Corgi, and then we have Luxury Deluxe, and Lux playing as well. And we have Shyvana called Summoner. So yeah, I think it's like everyone who was choosing those names is like they thought like Voodoo will be shoutcasting my game in like somewhere like 2 years in future, and they decided to pick names like this. So I need to work around them. But let me actually rearrange that the scoreboard on the bottom of the screen. So in the meantime, since like nothing much is happening, the current objectives for those teams is getting as much gold from the minions. Those are the NPCs that are just mindlessly walking to their death following their prime directive, and just mindlessly sacrificing themselves for their side. That's also the number next to the portrait right here. And Ooh, that's a nice exchange. Empower. Regular Q from Karma. Summoner just walking by through the mid lane, just showing himself. And now Joe will have to play safely. He will need to back in the lane a bit, since he now knows that Summoner is in top side of the jungle. But Joe is just standing in the bush there, like nothing's happening. And Galen doesn't know that he is actually there. But that was not really a surprising attack right there. So Beast ghosted, Anchor from Drello landed, and the Thunderlord proc from Karma secures the third kill in game number one, where it is hostile or AFK against a Fabulous 5. And since more damage, that was unfortunate kill right there. Looks ultimate, but it will cost Lux Theatric Corgi and his Lux. It will cost him health as Zyra picks up the kill out of nowhere, because you know, supports are supposed to follow their supports, the other team supports, to the as they're roaming. So definitely good job there for Asuka, getting the kill on the mid lane while managing to push Finest Ezreal out of the range, so he cannot last hit. Really nice. Ultimate coming down, but there is a TP coming behind them. Note is cut out. We will see how Galliant will be able to. That's a lot of damage coming down from Galliant on Note, and the vitals will be hit. And Summoner ultimate was blown, but it looks like they will be just rotating for that Earth Dragon. Cyanide Acid is preparing that nice empowered Q from him, securing the kill on the luxurious Ezreal. And Acid is just looking for more. The Asuka, managed to push the enemy team away. Unfortunately, Dragon could not be stolen at that time. Back of Beast. Ooh, that was a nice flash. Cyanic Assad had to dodge the ultimate from Corgi, and he decided to flash aggressively in through the wall instead of in back into the river and finish the kill on Back of Beast. That was a really nice done from him. And in the meantime, my co-shotcaster just sitting there in amazed silence, looking pretty for the camera. No, excuse me, he was not sitting and looking pretty. He was just trying to fix it, and he broke it in the process, I think. Nope, cannot hear you there. And Galliant finds Joe there, and Summoner flies over the wall as in his dragon form, just only to give a double kill to the Garen. Last Garen we saw on our stream was played by Solvia, and it did not fare well for that Garen's play that Solvia was showing. And right now we see, ooh, that's an ultimate from Note, a really nice shackle coming down from Asuka to enable to secure that kill. Really nice, good job, really nice down. And in the meantime, B has the mid lane turret almost down to half the hit points. of course, the top tower was taken for first tower of the day. Nice. Unfortunately, Asuka Root did not land there. Sanada Acid was not able to stay in range for a Root either. So B just had to get away with his. Yes.
Oh, I'm confused, bro. You got me whacked, jacked, and cracked. You're sharing me on Google Chat, right?
Yeah.
For the video. I had it muted. I was something else. I'm like, what's going on? Nobody can hear me. I'm sad.
Yeah, okay. I totally agree there with a glow that it's weird that B playing mid, and that was a bait from Bagus B, and he's not following up, and Karma shielded and might be able to get away. Come on, Karma. Nope. But looks like Derulo will. Yeah, it's shut down, and that was a flash auto attack provided by Asuka. By the way, Glow, that's how you're supposed to do it. And Ignite secures the kill on the Joe. I think it's like it's going a bit into YOLO game, since it's like a play after the beginning of the game. That was like a really, everyone was playing carefully, and now all consideration was just a blowout into hell, as we are 16 minutes in and there's already 6,000 gold difference in advantage of someone. Of hostile and AFK. That is really, really unfortunate there. Yeah. AFK, do I have it right? Yeah, I have it right there. So right now it looks like the team AFK is just steamrolling the game. And note, his ultimate just shoots in the middle of nowhere. Just a typical Lucian drive by. I wish Note managed to one more auto attack cancel there. That could have been a nice kill. And in the meantime, Gallant is actually trying to hold the line. And Joe is being baited under the tower, but that doesn't matter. Sand Acid is paced with his life for these plays. This game is going ludicrous. It's just crazy as it's how it's just play after play. And unfortunately Bag of Bees was disconnected there. That's my fault, I didn't notice that. That explains why he was standing under the tower there for those while Cyanide Acid was poking. Even though it's 15-5. Ooh, yes, it was Tura destroyed. You heard it. It's officially confirmed from our second shoutcaster. That's.
Well, if you were streaming me some good quality video, I'd be a little bit better
in it. Yeah, I see that slideshow, man, over there when I look at the second screen.
Probably be better off actually, like,
well, grab a chair and get next to me.
mean, I'm trying. I'm watching blue guys beat crap out of red guys and things flying, and then you're talking about stuff, and I'm like, oh, okay, I see. That's more like I'm spectating than actually watching it.
What? What's the difference between spectating and watching it?
No, I mean, it's supposed to be like, and in the, where they got what, 5 yards to go, third down, and this is it, folks. This game is almost over.
This is not football. But, yeah, I don't know if, yeah, I know what you're saying. I don't know if I can get to that point.
15, 5, 24K, 33K, I see all that good stuff, but it's like chop, chop, and I see, boom, disconnected, dude. And it's like,
And that is a 5-man collapse on poor Bees on the mid lane. He did not stand a chance over there. That was just him staying in at the wrong time, in the wrong spot.
Red turret destroyed.
And that is red team surrendering the game number one.
I have a question.
Yes, ask.
Who am I supposed to be rooting for?
Well, technically they're both teams from same community, so you can just flip a coin and just root for one of them.
Okay, go teams.
Yeah,
go team USA.
Fab 5 versus AFK.
Yep, that's
all part of the same Momentum Gaming.
Like, yep, really? they're both Momentum Gaming teams that are in the same skill range, so to speak.
Okay. So I love them all. I love you all.
No, it's like you need to show love to one of them. One of the team, not one of the teams, like one of the players. Like you pick the player.
Guy with the bag of bees, man. I mean, who could not like that name? I mean, it's a bag of bees, bro.
I mean, he has to have a balls to have a bag of bees. I mean, that's for sure.
Who would walk around with a bag of bees?
Well, obviously a bag of bees.
Does it mean there's honey in the bag? Can you squeeze the bag and get honey?
I don't know. We can ask him in after game interview.
I mean, think about it theoretically, like in your mindset, think the game genre and then like some weird thing like the Lord of the Rings, and this dude's just walking with a bag of bees, right? So he gets hungry, he stops, and he squeezes the bag on some bread,
and he gets
honey toast.
Yeah, but it's like if he squeezes it, he's gonna kill the freaking bees, or he's gonna get bazillion steaks.
A little honey.
Sugar.
sugar. Oh, honey. Okay, yeah, we don't sing. Screw that shit.
Yeah, it's a bad.
Okay, and in this corner we got everybody on the left and everybody on the right. I mean, I'm sorry, folks. I'm like a Company of Heroes kind of guy. So I'm working on this. Gotta watch it.
Yeah, give him a couple panzer tanks and
give me some panzers.
he's your best pick right there.
What'd you say? I'm old? Screw you.
I would never ever dare to suggest that you are old.
What?
But Wonky Tonky Magic Man is saying that he would not squeeze the bag if he was you, which I totally agree.
No, bro, you're not squeezing it to kill the bees. You're just squeezing them to get shit honey out of the bag. I actually think it's like a burlap sack, sort of, where the ooze would come out.
That's still, in some ways...
No way, dude. Have you had fresh honey out of the hive?
Yes, I actually did. It's really tasty.
It's dope.
Yep. And it's like most of the people, I don't think most of the people would actually like it, because like when you actually have it, it's like all like, it's not clear. It's not clear. It's like it has stuff in it.
Right, right. But they're thinking, did they add sugar to it? Is it really sweet?
And in game number two, there have been some substitutes going left and right. We have our amazing and awesome leader, MG Glowsticks, now playing there. And we saw on the side of Fabulous Gaming, we see Galliant locking in Camille, our favorite dragon, the only dragon that's actually useful in this game, Shyvana, followed by Malzahar. That's a Vi. That's even better, in my opinion, right there. We will see how it fares for the... for the game. In the meantime, we saw a bans, change of bans, like totally different. We have Zyra banned, so I do understand that they don't want Asuka having that Zyra again. Well, we followed by Vayne and Kalista, kind of unusual picks, in my opinion. And then we have kind of more standard Hecarim, followed by Blitzcrank. I mean, guys, you're supposed to be high elo. You're not supposed to be banning Blitzcrank. Come on. And... oops. And that's a video connection lost to our shoutcaster. We see only his beautiful yellow globe. In the last ban was the Aurelion Sol, the most useless dragon in the League of Legends. Even though that he's supposed to be like almost godlike. But that is final pick for Theatic for the Fabulous Five. A Mumu. We saw some pretty sick plays yesterday with Mumu's. With Mumu's ultimate. Followed with the Jax stun there and Janna ult on top of that. I actually don't know if the how it chains together. If the Amumu ultimate is cast first and followed up by Janna ult, I don't know if the people will actually stay in place or if it will kick them out from center of the Janna's ult still. I don't know if they are rooted or not. We will see. I would actually like to see that scenario. How it's going to be played out. We have a Varus, the Glow's go-to AD carry at this point. And on the other side, we have Vi, Malzahar, Zilean, Tryndamere, and Kannen. So, I think everything... that's like just Team Cancer on both sides.
Don't be mean.
I'm not mean, I'm realistic.
Did you just say Cancer?
Yes.
Is this rated R? Can I say bad words? I'm sure I did already. I'm just kidding.
And, unfortunately, we are losing the audience. People are running away from our stream. Shame, shame, shame.
What?
Yeah. Yeah, we just dropped 5 people in the stream.
Oh, I'm sorry, man.
Damn. You're not positive for my ratings, man.
That was pretty hurtful.
I'm sorry. I will bring you the beer or two when we are done.
Yeah, that was hurtful. It's not that, dude. I think what it is they want to see more aggressiveness. They want to see more dominance. They want to see some power. They want you to go hard, or they want you to go home. Let's get this game on.
But in here if you'd like. 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Oh, man.
Yeah, man, it's like, it's designed to protect so we don't cheat and we don't tell the other one team or another where the other team is, you know?
So it kind of does like a, just a default pause and then everybody's connected and then boom, it goes, kind of thing?
No, it's like, it will grab those 10 people that are actually playing, it will give them 3 minute head start and then it will right. let everyone watch 3 minute, So it's like everything that you do in a game doesn't have longer than 3 minute impact. It's actually 2 minutes.
So it's a delay for us?
Yeah, it's only the delay for the spectators.
But it still does like a round robin though, like the usual.
Yeah.
Okay. That makes sense.
Actually, that's a few things that Riot, the company that made this game,
so
makes sense.
We have to wait. It's kind of weird because I look over there, it's like 1 minute 30. Over here, it's like 1 minute 10. Like, it's really that delayed.
Yeah, on the Twitch, it's really that delayed.
So no wonder I can run down there and hand you a beer and run back up here and see me hand you the beer. Funny.
Yep.
I'm just kidding. I get it. I'm not that old. So 54 seconds and we get to see some action. But you guys, it's 108. And 5 people left, so call them and tell them to come back because we're not really that crappy of a host. I'm just like, you know, here and available, so I thought I'd dive in and be entertainment. But yeah. Mm-hmm. Don't know. I'll probably get banned and I'm not even connected.
That might happen.
They're going to say, who's that host guy? Get rid of that guy. He's like psycho. It's like...
Actually, the owner of this community, the MG Glowstay, that's the guy that with the purple avatar. Here, this guy.
Varus?
Varus, okay. Yeah.
So he's not mad at me?
Yeah. No, he has a nickname Hammer because he is swinging the banning hammer, and he just everything that lands gets banned.
What does that mean? I'm not cool.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I think you're cool.
I mean, I don't want to mess up your mojo and stuff. I mean, go with it. I mean,
no, you're not messing my mojo.
No, I'm just saying I'm available. I have a beer and. Yeah, let's do it. I'm just messing with you.
Fabulous, fabulous.
So you guys can't scroll down and like do the 3D view or nothing? You always got to stay on top?
Yeah, you can scroll down, but it doesn't...
Not spectator mode?
It just zooms in. It doesn't let you go in full 3D.
But I'm saying you can't roll down to like... You know what I'm saying, like in Company Heroes and stuff like that.
Oh yeah, you can do that. You can do that. I will show you when they are preparing before the action actually begins. So,
because I mean, some of these avatars are pretty damn, you know, exquisite.
Yeah, it's like one of the things that you might notice that Riot employees do really good is drawing boobs.
Which one? That one over there.
I see.
Oh,
yeah.
There's one there too, demon something or other.
Yeah, demon by. So yeah, they're doing a good job. I mean, front boobs, side boobs, under boobs, you name a boob, they have a boob.
So the name of the game with this is like, I guess that each person has their special ability, which is obvious, and then it's just the mix on. Pretty much beating the booty out of each other kind of thing. I mean,
yep, it's basically it's like every champion, there's like,
change each item because I see these little icons underneath. I mean, is it different weapons, is it different skill sets, is it different tactics, do you have to earn it?
Yeah, let's show up the board.
What is cyanic acid? Is that like something really dangerous?
I don't know. But look at that. Look at that. That's flying. That's flying boobs right there. It's like.
Right. That's cool.
And you can just.
But that's what I'm saying. I mean, you
look like, right into the face. I mean, you can look at the. I can show you Frank. I think you will like Frank. Oh, he's not here. Frank just disappeared somewhere.
But I mean, before they prepare for their battle, they get to put certain weapons or certain tactics.
Yeah, so it's like they have each of them. They have four active spells that they can control, plus they have one passive. And then those are fixed on the champion, on the character they're playing. On top of that, it's like on the left side, you see it's like this guy has a teleport, he has flash that will let you dash in a certain distance over the through the wall, stuff like that. You can choose that. And then you have your ultimate, that is the fourth active spell that's like showed on these circles right here, which is when if they people use it, really big deal, because it usually have like long cooldown. It would be like something like equivalent of calling artillery barrage from Company of Heroes.
Is it like the same thing, like any kind of weird weaponry thing that, like you say, cooldown mode, like if they like shoot a machine gun or something, the barrel gets hot and it says, oh, I can't shoot for 5 seconds. Okay.
Yeah, something like that, yeah. You could say. And that is a level 2 gank, and that's
I like those little guys, the little helper dudes, they're so cool. They're like,
yeah, they actually called minions. I guess? I don't know. Oh, is it the yellow guys, right?
Yeah. Did you see the Minions lawnmower scene? The little movie they made? It was kind of cool. But no, those guys are little cool dudes. I dig those dudes.
Yeah, that's Flash and... Ooh, that just goes both deep. And that's first blast for Theatric Corgi, because that was a greedy, a really, really greedy. It was funny. Yesterday, we've been actually... There was a game... that was played, it was one of the teams, was called Seven Deadly Sins.
Yeah, I heard that. Where the guys were trying to define what they were.
Yeah, well, the only one that we actually managed to do was Wrath. But right now, Luxury trying to burst down Cyanide Acid, and he managed to flash away to safety with barely his hit points. So, okay, so this is like... These two guys on the top lane, that's like the red one with the big ass sword, that's Tryndamere. Mm-hmm. And his ultimate is that if he goes too low on hit points, he can activate it and he's immortal for that for certain amount of time, right?
Right.
So they're trying to outplay each other. So the guy in the blue trying to poke do enough damage over the time, not in single engagement, because Tryndamere can just turn on him and just burst him down. Ooh, that was...
You got two people that almost have the same identical thing. They just sit there and beat the crap out of each other.
Well, you cannot play against the same champion in a draft, so... It goes boiled down to, it's like, they have same endurance, so to speak, but not same skill set. And in that moment, it's like it can be on a par.
So that's more or less a game default, to where it kind of keeps you from having the exact same thing as anybody, any other player, any other opponent.
Yeah, it's like you have basically, when they are picking on the beginning, they have the pool of the champions like over 200. Unique champions, and once that champion is picked, no one else can pick it.
Did you say 200?
Yeah.
You can pick 200 variables, plus or minus all the little icon attachments.
Yep. Plus, on top of that, you have each champion has 6 slots for items that he buys for himself that are changing his stats in a different way, or are adding like some passive abilities to whatever he's doing. So yeah, there's a lot of possible combinations, but it actually boils down to, it's like for the champion, it's usually like there is only one or two right ways to do it. So it's like you will not see a champion with all the bazillion possible combinations of items, because those items doesn't work. So there's only few of them that are actually working for that. For that champion. And once the people find out the best combination, they will just stick with it for as long as it works. So it's like, it's kind of predictable. So it's like more you can affect with a pick of the champion than like picking some champion that's played often but playing him in different way. And I'm actually surprised, it's like they're playing really, really safe right now. After that, the first fiasco where they basically, the flash, the dashes that they used on the beginning, most of the time you save them just to escape, like last resort escape. And they just use it both actively to move in on an enemy. And they have a long cooldown. It's like they have like 300 seconds cooldown at the beginning of the game. So we just see like damage trade back and forth. And it's kind of passive and boring game.
That's a big dude right there.
Who's yeah, that? It's like in the.
Like a big rock guy.
Yeah, so it's like this blue guy, he gives, when you kill him, whoever kills him gets a buffs under him. It's like, you see that's like blue aura that Durello has now under him. And that, what it does, it shortens his cooldown reduction on spells. And it yeah, so he can use his abilities faster. And he's getting his resources back, which can be like either mana or a rage or whatever they use to actually as a cost for the spell, like equivalent of fuel or ammo for the Company of Heroes. And on top of that, there's the red guy.
Whoop. I think we need more monitors.
Right? I was telling you that.
I see why you mean you have four of them.
It's like...
It's funny because I'm watching, I mean, I got both full screen, right?
So yeah.
One says 8 minutes and 47 seconds, the other one says like 8 minutes and 30 seconds, and it's like, I'm completely confused. No, I'm just kidding.
And that's a flash ult from Summoner going there, and Asuka will not get away from this situation, unfortunately. And in the meantime, Finus, that was a nice stun done by Acid, and the around equal exchange in the damage.
They're all doing a fine job, though.
Yeah, so... Right now, the Zillion, actually his ultimate is Rewind Time, and he basically puts ultimate on him, and if he dies, it will revive him with 70% of his resources back up.
By default, the skill or whatever.
That was a nice bomb placing there. From Cyanide Acid. And in the meantime, Summoner engaged on Durello, but there's a three-man party waiting for them, and Voidlings Will it be enough? No, he... Oh, that was a lot of damage coming from that bomb. I was actually expecting that smite will save summoner there.
So, from what I understand, the object obviously is to battle. But I noticed that they're taking down the towers.
Yeah, because the towers, they will automatically attack anyone, any enemy champion in their way. Same will be with the minions. It's like if... No, they attack only the opposite side.
But yeah. Is that like capture the flag type stuff or?
No, it's like more like defend the tower. You try to get rid of them.
No, I mean, how do you get control of the tower?
You destroy it. It's like at the beginning, you have every tower is assigned to the team, and the only thing that the opposite team can do is destroy your tower. So you defend yours and try to destroy the enemy towers in the meantime. And after crazy exchange in damage and kills in a slight favor of Fabulous Gaming there, we are 12 minutes in the game, a barely 1,000 gold different, and that's Acid stuck again in Camille ultimate, but he will manage to get himself back into the under his tower, no problem. He already finishes Rod of Ages and gain a first stack on it, so for Camille, it will only grow harder and harder to kill and to trade properly. In the meantime, Galleon is just trying. Unfortunately, Joe got a minion blocked there. He couldn't follow up the Galleon and the damage that he was doing. Really unfortunate.
So in spectator mode, we can see the minimap. Do they see the minimap with the same?
Yeah, they see. Yeah, they basically see in the spectator mode. You see everything I see right now.
No, but do they see it as the actual players, to where they can see where the enemy's at, to where they can like kind of gang up on them, kind of thing, or is it just?
Oh no, they see. That's a nice fight. Ultimate coming from Asuka, and a note that was three takes cancelled from that, and Durello joins the fight, and that will be a stakes going down, but on the top lane counterplay is being played, and it costed Trindamir's health, and in the meantime, Team AFK manages to clean up the bot lane. Good execute on the dive there onto Corgi that was trying to run and hide in the protection of his own turret. But that is Team Fabulous 5 is focusing that top tower, and they will get that first tower gold. Galliant will be left there alone to receive the full bonus of 650 gold just for him, which is a huge boost, especially since he was not really allowed to farm, since he's 30 CS behind.
Those guys are so cute. The little minion bastards.
And you should see them a week ago. There was like the entire map was in Snowdown theme, and they were like wearing hats and hot caps with hot cocoa, and they were driving the cannon. It didn't actually have the wheels, but had the belts like the snowmobile. Yes, always looks really nice. And that's stun coming down, followed by the bandage from a summoner. Undying Rage triggered by Crazy Joe. Ooh, that was a really bad timing there. If half a second that ultimate landed, it would save his life. Theoretical Corgi manages to interrupt Note away from glow sticks, but even though it's Corgi is defending glow, it's still he's eating still a lot of damage there from both Asuka and Note. In the meantime, Summoner and Galleon's trying to get themselves that Rift Herald. It's they're way ahead of schedule, since they still had 4 minutes before that objective was due. It just tends to how much ahead they are that they could afford to spare the time for that objective this early in the game. And maybe we will see that bottom tower at falling, but I wanted to say it will be falling, but it will not anytime soon, since Cannon ADC. Just doesn't have a wave clear enough at this moment to keep the lane pushed enough for more than a couple minions at a time. And the summoner is just walking by into the lane, but there is a Durello in the enemy jungle behind the enemy lines. And he will get bracketed because a Camille is on top, is coming from one side, while his other, but a nice bandage ultimate coming from Summoner, followed by Note's ultimate, Jay's unbreakable falling in, and that is just a lot of damage, and a lot of spells just traded for one kill. That is it's nice to see that Finest Luxury managed to land his ultimate. You can see that a bit unfortunate tanking there, but someone managed to get away. Joe triggers the he actually manages to jump himself over the wall, and he goes ham, but his ultimate just expired and he will be taken down. Cyanide Acid just moves by, jukes everything he can, and oh my god, look at that. Is it the god? Is it the faker? That's the Cyanide Acid just running away, surviving everything the enemy team is throwing on him, dodging what he could, and he finally gets shut down after this really amazing adventure that he managed to pull out.
Good effort.
That was indeed good effort there.
He was holding on with like a sliver.
Yep, managed to sidestep almost everything, every skill shot they throw at him, and still kept running. That's the place that we like to see. I have to actually write this down so I remember to make a highlight of this game.
1849.
Yay. And as we speak, the AFK team was spotted in the pit on top of the Infernal Dragon. They did not start it, but they managed to take a vision in front of the dragon pit. So we'll see. I hope the both teams have a vision on the dragon, so they're not trying to go for it, but team Fabulous 5 disengaged and spread out, and now the AFK just pulled the dragon out of his pit, carrying it on the edge of the line, and they will manage to secure it unless no miracles still coming through from a summoner, maybe some. But the Chainless Corruption coming down from Glow, and that true damage coming from his E as he stack up his passive on Note's ADC cannon. That's something we do not see often. Cannon is normally mage, and now he is just playing with physical damage. But that's a dive under a tower. That was a good ultimate, and even though Durello's trying to pursue with Unbreakable, he cannot do anything. This summoner and his Mumu is too tanky. Luxury just jumps around Proxy's ultimate, and there's nothing Acid can do this time, as he was in a prison made out of Camille's ultimate. I don't know, you guys, what you how you like Camille, since she's a brand new champion, and I don't know if we will really see her coming into the LCS, but Camille still managed to TP to the bot, to the top lane, to pick up the wave that was pushing there, and prohibit Joe from pushing the line. But Gallant is found Joe in the jungle. The ultimate is available, and he will not need to trigger it. Joe gets away with just his heal from the rage. But a glow is under a tower that is getting dangerously low. But that action on the top, Acid is actually ulted himself, and he will trigger it and survives. Camille follows in. He will get burst down so hard by three members of the enemy team. And in the meantime, Glowstakes trying to win that poke. That was a really a nice down, a flash to avoid the stun from a node. Really, really nice right there. Luxury secures the kill, but the damage from Tryndamere's red still claimed his health. In the meantime, Corgi is just clearing the vision. They don't want to be seen. They want to sneak throughout their jungle and get some hold of this game.
So I see a lot of turrets dropping. So does that mean they gain ground? Does that mean they can spawn closer?
No, they spawn at the same point. But what it means is that they have, like, at the beginnings, like, basically the map is divided equally between both teams. And if you have in between the lanes that are on the top, mid lane and bot lane, this is the jungle. That's where with the river and all the paths with the big monsters are. So if you get yourself, if you manage to kill the enemy towers, the enemy have to retreat to protect those towers that are closer to his base. And that lets you roam around the enemy jungle so you can have more NPCs to kill, get more experience, more gold to yourself. And it gives you better control over the epic monsters. That's like the dragons. They give you huge buffs, like the red one gives you.
So as they gain territory, the monsters kind of go for their side.
No, they don't care. They're always neutral. It's just like you will not get contested as much because you're basically operating now on the front line instead of the behind enemy lines, so to speak. And you have the dragons that are spawning in this pit, and they do, it's like the fire one, it gives the infernal, it gives you 8% extra damage, which is huge. And the more of the same dragon you have, it actually stacks, so you get 8, 16, 24%, where so the red team now has the Infernal Dragon, so they have extra 8% extra damage. And the blue team, they managed to get themselves Ocean Drake that actually allows hit points regen faster, which is 4% extra regen on top of the regen that they already have. And they keep those buffs permanently throughout the game.
The time frame doesn't really matter. It's more or less as they make the accomplishments.
Yeah, but as a the champions level up, their spells are getting stronger, they get more items, and okay. certain champions have like the progress of the power of the champions is not linear. It's like it's more like curved graph. It's like some champions have power spike in like, let's say, 30 minutes in, and the longer game goes, then the less useful they become. And some champions are other way around, where it's like they're basically practically useless in the beginning of the game, and the longer the game goes, the more more powerful, the more advantages they become. So right now, it's like they're fighting over this neutral monster in minion. That's like Scuttlecrab. And why would that even be worth fighting? Worth a fight? It's Undying Rage, and it's like the entire team did not follow properly through. It's a Mumu managed to land his ult. Note triggers his ultimate as well. Not enough ticks coming through there, and they just get deleted one by one through Fabulous 5.
Man, that was some battling right there.
Yeah, and it all started because of that one guy that was just crawling through the river, minding his own business. But what? And there's a second one right here in front of the second objective, is the Baron. It's like Baron gives you 5-minute buff. Lot of it's like kind of empowered. It increases all your stats, and when you are nearby your minions, they get buffed as well. They do more damage. They have more.
Yeah, I just saw everybody jump up. Well, the blue team will
run. Yeah. I mean, they are now a 10,000 gold difference. It's like in most of the games, it's like if you have 10,000 gold, it's already gone for that team. It's like you, when there is a 10,000 gold difference, especially in the pro games, you're just praying for some holy Mary to happen that turns around the fight. And but the thing is,
Hail Mary.
Hail Mary. Yeah, sorry, not holy, hail. But the nice thing is like as
so you said pro game, so is this like basically a clan type skirmish going on here versus actual?
Yeah, it's actually there is like a global league that has like its own subsections in different continents. So you have North American, European. Then you have Brazil, Korea, China, Russia, basically every continent has its own league, and right. They battle for the sorta local championship, and the winners from the local championship are granted the tour for the world's championship that happens every year, and then it's like the best teams fight there. Pretty nice prizes. It's like the prize pool is like in millions of dollars for the winners.
That's it. Just kidding.
Yeah. So. That is. So right now, it's like as they just basically run through the base, these structures that are hiding behind the towers, inhibitors. And what they do is, if you kill them, a beautiful fight happening right now. Even though it's Acid managed to ult himself, he. Still survived somehow. Amazing. Yeah, but they will actually, unless they respawn, they allow the enemy team to go with the bigger monsters. that are more powerful and stuff. Oh, these ones that are on the mid lane right now. And that's the point of the game. Destroy this this Nexus. They are battling around furiously.
So basically their home camp for their little...
Yeah, yeah. Boom. Plus it's like all the structure.
Victory is ours! Victory!
Victory lies ahead. So it's like all the structures. It's like you need to kill them one by one because it's like the all structures behind the first one are invulnerable unless the first one is taken. So you cannot like
though, even though it's a little different than like Company Heroes or something, but it's like constant, like in your face.
Yeah, but they actually managed to tie up the game. Mm-hmm. So it's a one win for Fabulous Gaming, one win for AFK. So this is like it's all the games are played in best of three.
Right.
And but on the like international tournaments and stuff, the games being played best of five. If it's like the finals for championship or something like that. Yep. So it's like most of the time it's like of course the teams are want that first win in the series, but they are willing also to sacrifice it to like kind of try their way, and if it's if it doesn't go well, they just shift to the plan B that gets them the victory in the second and third game. I mean, obviously you want to play end it in between in those first two, but hell, it's the third games are the games that are always worth watching because like everyone is playing their best because they know it's like they cannot screw up. Yeah, so as they're picking, they have each team has three bans that's on top of here. So it's like they can each team can choose three champions they don't want to play against, and they change sides in banning the champions. So it's like they usually have knows like
that's like saying oh you can't bring tigers on the field.
Yeah, so it's like they like banned Amumu. No, it's like always the last three people in the list. Uh-huh. And the if they are
they get the ban, the last three only?
Yeah, last three on each side. They get to ban. And how they are actually show up in there, that's basically random, but since they are full team, they just discuss what would work, what would not work, what they are afraid of.
They're on team speak, strategizing.
Yeah, basically. So it's like they banned Amumu and Shyvana and Camille. It's like that made them that gave them a lot of trouble last game because Amumu was the green guy that cries around and he just. He just throws the bandage in and then he stuns everything around him. So they had a lot of problem with that. So I understand that the ban coming there.
So it's like a medic.
No.
You said bandage.
Oh, that's just he's mommy. So he just calls the
oh,
he throws the
bandage. Gotcha.
So he throws his. The spell is actually called like that, Band-Aid. There's actually only one true medic in this game, and that's Soraka, and it's like this funny purple chick that's like
Is she seeing anybody right now?
If you would see her, you would not want to see her.
Yay!
So, but they have a Hecarim, which is like like this mix of Ghost Rider with Kentaur, as like everyone calls him a Pony Ride Express. or My Fair Pony, depending on the skin, because he has like this skin with all the rainbows and is shooting from him and stuff.
Is there chicks playing this game?
Oh, hell yeah.
But I mean, are they really chicks? I'm just kidding, dude.
Yeah, and they are all lovely, and we love them and cherish them and protect them in our inside of our community. So they stay cool with us.
I'm not saying it like to sound like a weirdo or anything. It's just cool.
Yeah. So I'm actually captain of one of the teams that's like team like this, and I have there a girl playing. So
that's pretty cool.
Right, I know.
I would say that's hot, but that I guess sounds sexist or something. Just kidding. Sorry.
And the team, we see a Bard picked up. It's like guys with without a face. He just has a three dots instead of his face, and he.
Yeah, why don't you give us the rundown of for the home at home audience, these characters that we got going on here, bud?
Well, I don't need to give the home audience the rundown because they know all the champions.
I don't know, and tell me.
All right, so this guy, he is real. He's really agile and can move around a map a lot, so he will be in the jungle, you know, just jumping from the bushes trying to surprise you. Bard, he has a good crowd control spells, he has a stuns, he has a immobilize effect, so it's like he will be support. Karma, she has a lot of shields for her team if she desires so she will be playing, and she's mage, so she will be playing on the mid lane. Ashe, she's archer, she will be playing as a AD carry on the bot lane together with her support. The funny part is like she has this small quiver on the back of her back, right, where she's grabbing the arrows from that she shoots, and her ultimate is like this, a giant arrow that's like, it's like seriously giant. You will laugh when you actually see it. Darius, he's like basically your high school bully guy, that's just
yes, the high school bully
that just goes around and
beats
crap out of everything, and you cannot basically kill him because he's too dumb to feel pain.
Wow.
You saw the Jax, that is the guy that's like spinning the lantern above his head. He'll be on the top lane, he's really good at that. Vi, she actually has a police officer skin.
So when these people pick, they're locked in. And they're basically, can they see each other when they're picking?
Yeah. They see each other as a counter. Yeah, there was actually in draft pick, it's like 70 seconds, and it always goes, it first starts that one side is banning, it skips to the other player, one by one. And then where they're picking, it jumps to the first player, and that first person picks, and then it's like, but it goes but in pairs, so it's like they pick a Hecarim, so they pick the as a counter. They need to think like, hey, they're picking Hecarim, what we can play against that, what champion would work good, what can counter him, and etc. So they pick two champions they think would work best, and the enemy team now is picking, so they see like, okay, they responded to our Hecarim with
so forth. Do you think it's equal? I mean, it's pretty much a gamble as they're picking their characters and their spells per se, I guess.
Yeah, it's a gamble, and it's like you just want to. That's why it's like they are five men that they having trainings together, and they're trying to find that synergy between the champions. You know, it's like what fits their playstyle, what and what which champions actually work together.
Right.
So, and since there is a lot of combinations, and depending on a lot of situations, it's right now I would say it's unless they manage to control the high school bully guy, they have a really good chance, because they have a people that can match him with one-on-one slaughtering match, so to speak. But they need to focus, they need to prioritize the targets properly, and etc. And even though it's like while they can do it, they need to watch for the Hecarim. So Hecarim is like really fast, so it's like his main thing is like flanking from when you don't have a vision on him, and going for the ADC, that would be the Caitlyn. A chick with huge rifle. She has a nice Russian skin. She's like, she has AK-47 and all in snow in front of the Russian tank. That's something that looks like Russian tank. Yeah, so they need to balance that offensive of trying to get the enemy champions killed and trying to protect their own damage dealers. So this would be like tanks protecting the rear artillery installations, so stuff like that, kinda. Yeah. And you have tanks there that have like a huge hit pools, so they can body block the skill shots and etc. And so it's a lot of around the positioning and line of sight and stuff like that. And we are up to. We are down from 16 to 13 people. Ooh. It's still 3 people more than before. Yeah, and basically it's like this, the loading screen, the frames they have around them, that signalize what in the ranked games, what how high they ended up last season. So the highest ranking here would be the Asuka and Note that have a platinum borders. The rest have gold and silver, that's below platinum. And then they have like these individual badges, these little flags on top left that just shows how proficient they are with that champion they're playing.
Takes a while to get it started, yeah, that's crazy.
It's not actually like the start of the game. I think it's like they mostly have the problem with syncing everyone. Because how it works is like the connection goes to the server, and then when the server connects, confirms like all the 10 people are connected, it basically gives them peer-to-peer access to each other. And game number 3 from best of 3 is now started. The fabulous Fabulous Gaming, and of course I have the Here they are.
Welcome back!
Yay! Welcome back, everyone. So.
Welcome back.
So in 30 seconds, they start fighting. And we see it's like the Fabulous Five is guarding, protecting the access points, all the access points to their jungle, trying to prevent the invade. Where AFK team is just grouped around that red buff, most likely trying to give Durello the a smite less smiteless leash there. You'll see how it fares for both teams. I really want to see that Zerat Karma on the mid lane. Yeah. And we may have some minor damage be exchange on the top lane. Bot lane just trying to farm, getting themselves the extra gold they both need. That would be a binding coming down from Cyanide Acid for a bit extra damage and immobility on a fine luxury. In the meantime, Asuka is zoning out the dice stun there, binding landed by Asuka on a glow stick. That's a lot of damage actually coming there through. And we have a Hecarim trying to flank from behind, a speed boost given by Cyanide Acid, and the Pony Ride Express just arrived. Zerat has to flash away, but he keeps his health there. We'll see. Are we going to see a repeated gank? So, really quick. And no, it looks like that Durello is just checking the enemy jungle for blue, putting some deep vision wards in there, and is heading through the river, killing the Scuttle Crab for that extra gold. In the meantime, it was a Vi just passing by somewhere. That flash for securing the scuttle. Summoner cannot really follow up since Hecarim will get that speed bonus. Cyanide Acid though is collapsing, and there is Asuka there as well. But the Note is 1v1ing with the Sticks there. Sticks forced to heal, but the Note has the rapid fire active, and Sticks have to flash out of the range in order to keep his life. Gallant manages to trade equally with Darius there, but that will be becoming harder and harder with increased level. They both went for the corruption potion, but the Gallant already drinked all his charges from his potion, while Joe still have one charge left, and since it heals you and as well gives you extra damage there, this might be a first kill. The bleeding will not be enough, and thanks Galt, level up there for Galliant that healed him above the threshold, so he did not have to worry. But still, Joe is over double amount CS ahead of Galleon, even though they're managing to trade equally in limit spent. We see Galleon getting with the long sword and Ruby Crystal, of course, because I don't remember. That's how bad I am, I don't remember the name of the Ruby Crystal. And Grizzly just tries to put some damage down, stack himself that bleed damage. So far, always Gallant manages to dodge the most of the attack. But that was a nice damage exchange. There is a summoner coming on Cyanide Acid. Cyanide Acid actually baited the Ooh, that was really unfortunate. They're killed by Zerat after successfully disengaging from Avai. But he did actually turn around, step in that place, so Luxury had that time to get in position, cast a spell, get a kill.
First blood.
Yep, and with first blood is whoever gets first blood on the champion or on the tower gets extra 400 gold for that, which is lots of money. Since you're getting like from 17 to 20 gold for most of the minions. And that's a Gallant trying to go toe-to-toe against Grizzle, but that will ult not soon enough. The bleeding effects will not be enough either to kill. And that's both Gallant and Summoner flashing with that red indicator on the right side of the screen. Finest Luxury taking a lot of poke damage. Cyanide Acid managed to get himself those both the empowered and regular Qs on the target always, even through the minions. Really have to say job well done there for him. And in the meantime, Note, this time with a more standard pick of AD carry, the Ashe, trying to push for the objective. In the meantime, Summoner trying to get himself a solid dragon, but Cyanide, as it looks like, smells something going on. And even though he did not ward, Summoner was forced to disengage due to a risk of being caught and killed easily if Cyanide Acid actually noticed that there's something happening in the dragon pit. And the Pony Ride Express looks going next destination will be Scuttlecrab. And the top lane is just Hecarim rushing, trying to get behind Gallant. I think he could have gone through the lane, but that was a flash, and unfortunately that flash was not awarded with a kill, since the kill was taken by Durello, but that's still assist by Grizzly. Ultimate from Asuka, nice binding, landed on Corgi as a follow-up. Unfortunately, even though it's a Cyanide Acid, ulted himself to get there fast enough, there was not enough damage going through, and in the meantime the Vi just burning through the Joe's hit points. That through damage and percent health point damage is really incredible. In the meantime, Durello just cleans up that that ward. That's 75 gold denied to the enemy, and 30 gold into his own pocket. Something that every support would be glad for. And in the meantime, that's nice counter stun from Finest Luxury. And that is the damage being done by Note on the tower. Ghostix trying to poke, trying to push the Asuka away, and Durell doing his duty as a jungler. He's countering the enemy vision, and while securing the vision for his team, and he is trying to engage. He's waiting, and he will be caught back there by Vi, but Vi just goes by, doesn't know Gallant get his arrow right into the face, and in the meantime team just Fabulous Five just tries to disengage, but Glowstick is cut on the front line with the Joe just slamming ultimate, and those resets, look at that, that's a quadra kill coming there for Grizz Joe. 11 minutes in. That's why you don't feed Darius after the midnight.
There's a lot of traffic going on right there.
Yeah, that's really unfortunate. One of the Darius ultimate that Grizzly Joe has, the bully guy, is if he manages to ult and kills the target, his ultimate cooldown is rainbrewist by some percentage. I mean, in the end of the game, it's basically he gets a free reset, but in right now, even so, it's since he was level 9, so it's just first level ult, so it was just enough to get those resets on 4 members. That's still crazy. That's, and Luxury is just trying to get some damage done on ultimate, but Cyanide Acid decides to go into the counteroffensive, so Luxury has to break his ultimate. He didn't want to be caught down with his pants on his knees. Summoner and his Unbreakable following in. That will be a nice ultimate there coming from a Bard, but did not hit anything, unfortunate. The Jason Durello, he gets he's trying to run down the Theatric Corgi and his Janna, but so far it looks, ooh, that is another kill into the pocket of Grizzly Joe. The bully is definitely working, doing his job. That's a attempt to steal blue, and it did not go through. The Zerat managed to land the stun, but countered by the damage from Cyanic Acid's Q. The Fabulous 5 is rotating for the mid lane since the bottom tower is was lost and the top lane tower is gone as well. So they have a 4-man. It's a 4v2 on the mid lane, but they decide to actually cut off a node that is just a BMing in the jungle, showing no respect. And seeing the node. Seeing note that he doesn't back off, even though he's the only person visible, the enemy team just stands down. They don't want to chase into the fog of war without any knowledge what might be waiting there. And we are 15 minutes in. So far we have a 4,000 gold lead in favor of team AFK. So far that all the gold is actually placed on Grizzly Joe and his Darius. So we might see, I mean, the Darius has 5 kills, that's already, there's nothing to be done about that. He will be dangerous throughout the end of the game. It's just that sort of champion that once you get him rolling, it's really really hard to stop him, even though it's like he starts dying in the late game. But nothing is lost yet. We need to believe that Fabulous 5 manages to get themselves some awesome play that will turn the ties soon. And by soon I mean in around 10 minutes the Baron starts to becomes an objective. Cyanide Acid, actually, that's a really brave from Summoner, just farming while his teammate is being poked down, and the Cyanide Acid needs to flash over the wall, but will get down by Jace. That's a Hecarim going down to a glow stick. Darius just going ham. Arrow hit us. That is two players out of the equation there, but Darius will fall down, and that is a 3-4-1 trade. And note with Asuka have to retreat. There's nothing they can do about it right now, and that will mean mid lane tower falling down for the Team Fabulous 5, and that's something that's exactly what we need to see. They managed to get themselves 3 kills. They managed to reduce the gold deficit from 4 to around 2,000 gold. They managed to chunk down the mid lane tower, but now they need to defend their own mid lane tower, which so far looks like the Xerath on its own has no problem. The ruler gets away with just barely any hit points left. Really unlucky there for Luxury, because he could use those kills for his advantage. And we will have a dragon spawning in 10 seconds. It will be Earth Dragon, and Earth Dragon, it will be first Earth Dragon in this game. And since Earth Dragon gives you the ability to increase damage to structures as a turret and nexus, and that will be that Gallant there, unfortunately. Nothing to be done about that. Grizzly Joe just runs down. He is the Juggernaut. And unfortunately, the summoner picked up by both Hecarim and Arrow from Ashe. But look at that shield. That is ridiculous. Only the damage from Note manages to pierce that shield. The flash forward, trying to get run down the glow stick. The ultimate will land, and that is unfortunately glow stick just being left to die, so Note can pick up the kill for himself. We see some nice kill discipline coming from a team AFK. They know who has the priority on their team in receiving that gold from kills and from a CS. In the meantime, Asuka just journeys away from Luxury's Ranch, and that's a Jace trying to run down Finest. There will be no problem killing him, as the four members of Team AFK brackets him, and he has nowhere to run with his ghost being already used. Especially with duos of champions like that have a ghost, whoever a ghost first usually lose the fight, since the other person can just run it down. Nice tower dive coming there from Durello. He managed to get himself a Jaina for his trouble, followed by Note killing a glow stick that was cut out by the charge from the Durello. The ultimate is being spring by Luxury, but not much can be done. The tower still goes down with any chance to kill, but look at that auto attack speed coming from the Gallants. Like, the animation, it doesn't even trigger properly anymore. It's just that fast. That will make, if they can actually get to the point where a Gallian can steamroll that sideline while Darius is not around, that could lead them to the potential victory. I mean, they managed to get themselves extra outer turret. That is two turrets on Fabulous side versus four turrets taken on the AFK side, with a gold lead ranging right now around those 5,000 gold. And both teams are actually setting up around that Baron pit. There is a summoner trying to bracket Grisbo, and he has the damage there should be enough, but the that's just unlucky as hell. All three members caught out in the Bart ultimate. Glowstick manages to flash, but there's nothing he can do. He bracketed himself inside of the red pit as Luxury manages to stun Durello, but Corgi still pays with his life. Note in the meantime, just hammering the mid lane tower, and that's two turrets on top of the four kills picked up by MG AFK. I mean, you know you're behind when Bard support tries to pick up a jungle to get himself some extra gold income. I don't know why Gallant is even trying to go for it. A summoner is there again, but he will have soon Bart joins the party, and he will not land. But that's a Joe. Just look at the damage he's taken, and still manages to, in face of four enemies, he still manages to take a one down. And that is White with Summoner trying to run away, but Asuka trying to slow him down. Grizzly just picks up another kill. Binding landed on the Corgi, granting the kill. Luxury just body blocking for a Summoner, trying into the range, but the Pony Express arrived at the destination. And that was a demise of a Summoner there, and his vibe. That will be a free top tower followed by inhibitor, as well as bot line inhibitor. The Bart ultimate did not catch anything except a couple minions, a bit extra healing, you know, just because we have those redemptions available. I mean, why not, right, guys? And in the meantime, Asuka just showing us the penguins flying through the magic journey. That will be Infernal Dragon spawning in 10 seconds. Team has to actually wait after securing the scuttle. That's a just arrow, and it actually managed to land it across the map. Oh my god. Glow. And Grizzlo just showed up trying to run down something, but as soon as the members of Fabulous Five see Grizzly, they just run away as fast as they are capable. Considering that's only one member of AFK, that is really unfortunate. And right now we are on a 13,000 gold lead in advanced stage of AFK. It would take a miracle right now for the Fabulous Five to actually come out of this. But since the team of Fabulous Five is not playing in their regular setup, since Baron being interrupted just for lols there by Asuka, because
it's pretty much late.
Yeah, he was just trolling his own his own teammates because they can afford it. They have so much head start that there is not much that Fabulous Five can do to really turn around that that game. Yeah, that is a Grizzly Jones trying to get himself a blue buff for that extra cooldown reduction, but it looks like it will not be needed because a Note is just clearing everything and Durello just flies through the Fabulous Five, taking landing his CC, allowing a Note to get himself an unofficial quadra kill. Durello is actually had forced to flash, so the last hit from the ultimate doesn't land. But right now, that's a last tower going down, with Nexus being next objective in there, and that will be one dead shut down Darius, but it doesn't matter. The Baron empowered minions managed to shatter the Nexus, and Team Momentum Gaming Hostile or AFK is winning this series 2-1 in best of three against Fabulous Five. Again, this was a match that was originally set up to be playing with a totally different community, but unfortunately I guess they got scared by Hostile or AFK, and I think it was good that they got scared, since Hostile showed up that they can play, they can make plays, and they can take the at least a victory in in-house scrim. So with this, I am sorry guys again for the technical difficulties. There've been retarded amount of time on the beginning of the stream where nothing was going on. We were waiting, trying to remake the games, and
I tried to fill in the gaps.
Yes, that's true. We had our chief backup entertainer here.
And chief beer drinker.
Yeah, chief beer drinker, because there's not enough beer. Cheers.
Oh, I've been getting served. Do you want me to send some beer down to you?
No, I didn't have much opportunity to actually drink mine. So
I did so much talking, bro, I just stopped. You got into the mojo, I was like, okay, go with it. I don't know what I'm looking at. Bombs.
So we have at this moment there are no scheduled games for next week, but remember there's always in-house ARAM going on in the Saturday. We might have some in-house scrim going on between the bronze teams, but that's just a subject to change yet. And to all those 9 people that actually managed to survive this entire length of this broadcast,
there was 9 people that were steady.
We started with 22, and the weaklings just we left them behind, and only strong prevailed.
Passed out though, maybe.
Yeah, this is the weak guys. It's like you need to get rid of the weak links in the chain first, and only the strong 9 prevailed. So thank you very much for watching, guys, and I hope to see you next time in a game that goes totally according to the plan with all the software and hardware provided, and have a good night.